15. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And 10. It's Griffin. Flush to his right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Darren Waller, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off. It made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It's a gain of 7, and that'll bring up 4th down.
It's 4th down.
They'll indeed go for it with Griffin. He's going to rifle one deep left, and that's caught inside the 35. The ball comes out, and this one's going to go out of bounds, so no recovery, but on 4th down, a change of possession anyway.
At the 28-yard line.
Throwing now, Griffin on 1st down, escaping the pressure right. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Dez Bryant, 28 yards, and the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And the Ravens lead it 7-0.
Is good. Makes the score our home team 7. Visitors nothing. Adam Vinatieri.
It is Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. There defensively to knock it away was the safety, Justin Reed. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Throwing again. Rodgers eluding the pressure right. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver. And it's 3rd down.
Incomplete. It's 3rd down and 10 yards to go.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. Open man, there is Patterson, complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That gain on 3rd down, good for 28.
A 1st down.
On 1st down, Rodgers. Got a man, it's Randy Moss, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Throwing on 1st down is Rodgers. This will be caught by Randy Moss. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. It's another 1st down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards. Rodgers to throw once more. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it a 2nd down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 21. Two yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes.
And the pressure getting to RG3. He's brought down for the sack. Montez Sweat in there to bury him for a loss of 11. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Bryant with a catch right side. And he'll be stopped here well short of the first down at the 24-yard line. 12 yards. The Ravens send their punter out now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon.
That's the end of the first quarter, with the score Ravens 7, visitors nothing.
The Ravens send their punter out now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this will do the job nicely, as that'll be out of bounds just inside the 10-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the level of
pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Geno Atkins got home that time.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall, and they could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
He's got a man complete. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. A gain of right around 30 on a play that began way back inside the 5. Rodgers now on first down. Got a man, it's Randy Moss. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
24 yards.
Call that a very strong gain of 24.
First down.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. Here's Moss with a catch out of the backfield. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. To throw again, Rodgers. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked up by 9-time Pro Bowler Ed Reed. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Gets it up around the 22 and no further. Did show some power on the run, but not a whole lot of room.
That's a 22-yard line.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't.
And the pressure getting to RG3. He's brought down for the sack. I don't think that was a blitz, was it?
No, not at all. I mean, there was no blitz called on the play. Had other responsibilities, but he saw an opportunity, saw a path, and he took it.
action here defensively. From the shotgun, Griffin flushed out right. He'll look downfield for Waller. And that is incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
And the punt goes out of bounds, so no chance to bring it back, and they will spot it at the 24-yard line.
At their own 24-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my...
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Montez Sweat. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. 16 yards, a first down.
Results in a first down.
Working from the gun, Rodgers, flush to his right. That's complete to Moss out of the backfield. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. That's complete to Calvin Johnson. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. The end result, 21 yards.
And a first down.
Rodgers again now. And this is caught at the 8. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. Brandon Ayuk, the one he was looking for. But now it's third and goal. And again, it's Rodgers. And it's caught. Touchdown. Maurice Jones-Drew. There to make the grab. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So a late touchdown here just before the half, and that obviously changes the dynamic of this game.
Yeah, in a couple of ways, partner, because they've been shut out up into this point. So now at least they go into the locker room, and Uncle Mo may be creeping over to their side to talk to him a little bit. And second, they're right back in the football game, an extra point away from tying things up.
Janikowski good with the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Raven's going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Out of the gun, Griffin. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Incomplete. It's now second and 10.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
They'll take over first down and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line ready for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Looking for Ayuk, and he's got him.
Rogers.
Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
5 yards.
Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy on the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progression, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
Rodgers now on first down. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down.
On the coverage.
To throw again. Rodgers. That's complete to his receiver, Ayuk. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Results in a first down.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. That's complete out left to Ayuk. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Dancing to his left. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Justin Reed. The 40. Past the 20. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for 6.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
They'll take over first down and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The offense now at the line ready for their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
To throw again on second down, Rodgers. On the slant, able to find Ayuk. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
side. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
That's back now in Baltimore. It's the Ravens in control of the football. They've also got the lead as we get set for the fourth. Tackle on the run, and then just on the other side of midfield, they get to it. 6 yards there on the keeper. It's second down.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
This time, Griffin will throw. And the pressure getting to RG3. He's brought down for the sack. Jadeveon Clowney showing the explosiveness on the sack. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, it's Griffin. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down.
11 yards. It's fourth down.
Take it all the way down and just take the delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. The Ravens send their punter out now as he's on here to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
First down and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Now Rodgers. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception. Hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a two-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
And they will not get a chance. chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. Here's second and 10. Back to throw, Rodgers. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 21. That one goes for 24 yards. Rodgers to throw. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. The sack there by J.J. Watt. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to get it back to a one-score game. And Janikowski bangs it through, and they're back within a touchdown at 17-10. So chalk that down as an eight-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
A fairly short kick from the 14, and he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 and the 24. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show.
We got a play to catch.
Brings up second and 11 at the 23-yard
line. On second down now, it's Williams. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
I think it might be time to move to a different section of the playbook there, because back-to-back runs, both for loss. Now they have third and long coming up.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will fight his way forward to about the 23-yard line. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Oh, trying to gauge the sun, and he muffs it.
They'll take over. First down and 10 at their own 12-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
Back to throw. It'll buy some time right. Now a desperation throw deep